All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Cristobal Garcia-Huidobro. He is the Managing Director and CEO of Lithium Power International Limited. And Cristobal, it's great to see you. How are you?
Hi, how are you, Steve? Nice to see you too.
Yeah, I'm doing very well, thank you. And really interesting news out from the government in Chile. They've put out a new lithium policy as regards to obviously the look at that resource within the country. And just before we get to the announcement itself, I want to take a step back here. You've obviously been talking to the government of Chile for quite some time leading up to this announcement. Is that correct?
Yeah, it is correct. We have had some busy days here in Chile during the last, you know, 3-4 days with this policy. But yes, you're right. We have been working with the Chilean government for the last 7 years developing this project. This is our third administration at this point. We started with the former president, Bachelet. And this is by far today, not only the only project outside the Atacama Salar in Chile, but it's by far the most advanced project we have in Chile today.
So the new national policy was announced, and was there anything there that has surprised you at all, or could have any impact on the company or the project?
No, not really. It's if you see the policy, you have two, you know, different things there. One is on the way in which the project needs to be developed from now on, which is actually a very good reflection of what our lithium power project is, you know, the way in which we have been relating ourselves with indigenous communities, the way in which we address all the technical thing, and how impeccable, you know, from an environmental point of view is the project, but mainly this social, you know, issue is one of the things that the government was looking the most now, which is what we have done and what they expect for the new projects to do also by incorporating all the communities since the first day of the development, for those communities to really have something to say, you know, on the design and all the decisions of the project. And most importantly, for those to participate in the future benefits the projects will generate throughout all, you know, its mine life, which is exactly, you know, what we have in our project. This is probably one of the only projects, mining projects in Chile, that has an indigenous consultation under the ILO 169 convention that actually protects indigenous rights for the people. So on that side, you know, nothing was new for us. This was exactly what we have been talking with the government for the last probably 9 months now. And now on the side of this participation of the government, it's very important to differentiate what's really happening in the Atacama Salar, which is today the only salar that is producing in Chile. The Atacama Salar is where Esquim and Albemarle are located. And that salar, different to all the other ones in Chile, the owner of that salar is the state. The owner of the mining concessions at that salar is the state. So actually what the state do is to lease those mining concessions to two different operators today, and, you know, for them to be able to exploit. And those operators has, of course, those contracts, those leases, has some, you know, conditions. And in the case, the one in the case of SQM will be due by 2030. The one of Albemarle that was recently renewed will be due in 2043, I think it will. Different to us, in the case of Lithium Power, we are the owners of our mining concessions. So this participation of the government will be completely different. And of course, in our case, we embrace this national lithium policy that was just released, because it will accelerate the way in which the government will be able to get involved in all the other projects in where they don't have the control of the assets. And of course, that will also accelerate the development of the whole industry. For the last 35 years, we have only had two producers in the country that has the biggest reserves, you know, in the world. And we only have two producers. That's something that change.
Yeah, it's amazing. So let's just really quickly, as we wrap up here, talk about your project specifically. I know it's fully permitted for construction. It's large, it's well advanced. So what stage are you at right now, and what's the next stage for everyone to be aware of?
Okay, we are at this moment, the only milestone we have ahead of us is to be able to finalize the financing structuring of the project. We divided the project into two stages. For the stage one, where we will produce around 16,000 tons of lithium carbonate battery grade for 20 years. That's a $600 million capex project. What we are at this point doing is, you know, managing all these approaches that we have been receiving during the last months, you know, from different interested parties, both on the side of, you know, becoming a strategic equity partner or, you know, directly to acquire the whole company. We expect to be able to finalize that, you know, financing process before year end, during the fourth quarter this year, and immediately after to start the construction. This is a project, like you said, is a fully permitted project. We received our environmental approval by the beginning of 2020. That environmental approval by, you know, that was given by the Chilean government, of course. That environmental approval was ratified by the Committee of Ministers in Chile, again, the Chilean government, by the beginning of 2022 now. Today, we're, you know, ready to start the construction. We have all the permits needed. All the supplies have been secured. Salar transmission line is operating. The water is secure, etc. So the only milestone we have ahead of us to close the financing, final investment decision, it's kind of taken already. So the moment we're able to do that, we will immediately after start the construction.
Well, it certainly is exciting times, and I'm glad that the new national lithium policy in Chile is going to work for the company as well. So, Cristobal, thank you so much. Great update, and good to talk to you as well. Good luck with everything.
Thank you, Steve.
All right, there's Cristobal Garcia-Huidobro. He is the CEO Managing Director for Lithium Power International Limited.